The Torah in Parshas Bahar tells us that when an individual who is impoverished comes to any of us, we should respond by doing the following. The Torah uses two words as a description. Vehechezakta bo. We should strengthen that person. And Rashi explains what does it mean to strengthen that person. Rashi says that the individual is beginning to fall down. And we shouldn't let the person fall down. Rather, we should grab them and hold them up so that they don't fall. Because if a person falls all the way down, it's impossible, virtually impossible, for the person to rise back up to where they originally were. It's very difficult, very challenging for a person to be able to do so. So don't let them fall there in the first place. And Rashi brings a mashal, and he explains that it's as if there was a heavy load that was on a donkey. And this heavy load was slipping off of the donkey. Now, this heavy load was too heavy for a person to carry. But if a person sees that the heavy load is slipping off the donkey, and they simply put their hands up to try to catch it and keep it on the donkey, to keep it balanced on the donkey, that's what the Hechazakta Bo is about. But if the heavy load falls off the donkey, then that one person, he has no way they could possibly pick up the load and place it back on the donkey, because he needs at least five people, since the load is so heavy. And once it's already off, and once it's on the floor, it fell. It's not that it's impossible, but it's very difficult to lift it back up and place it back on. They need other people's assistance. So the Torah says, "Vechazakta bo," strengthen the person who's falling down. Don't let them fall too far. Strengthen them. Make them feel better. Reb Chaim of Tzanz was once approached by a woman on the latter part of the week, perhaps it was an Erev Shabbos, and this woman said to Rav Chaim that she didn't have money to buy food for Shabbos. And he looked surprised. He said, well, don't you sell apples? I see you time to time selling apples in the marketplace. What happened? And she responded, and she said, I don't know, people aren't buying the apples. Immediately Rav Chaim stood up and walked to the marketplace and came to her stand where she was selling the apples. And he said, people, listen. There are beautiful and tasteful apples that are being sold here. Everyone come and buy apples. Great apples. And sure enough, people saw that here Rav Chaim of Tzanz is selling apples. So they went and bought from him. But they didn't only buy it for how much they cost, that they were willing to pay even more than what it cost, than what it was cost. Because here Rav Chaim of Tzanz is selling the apples. And sure enough, before it turned around, the woman had sold so many apples that she had plenty of money, certainly to buy herself food for Shabbos. And as Reb Chaim Tzanz was walking away and the woman was expressing her gratitude and her thanks to him, he responded by saying, look, I didn't do much here. You see how good your apples are? I told you, your apples are good. It's just that people didn't know. Now, what did Reb Chaim Tzanz really give this woman? Did he give her money? No. What did he give her? He strengthened her. He told her how great her product was and that she had the ability to sell it herself. It was only a question of marketing, so he taught her a little bit about marketing, perhaps. But what he did was he strengthened her as she was falling and didn't allow her to fall all the way down. And ultimately, that is what the woman needed in order to get herself back on her feet, in order to make sure that she had food, not only for that Shabbos, but for many Shabboses into the future. We're still in a difficult time financially. There are still people who are struggling here locally in our community and beyond in many communities. It's important for us to try to help those people. If not financially, it's important for us to try to help them by keeping them in mind when it comes to other jobs, when it comes to sending a resume for them or hearing about job openings, or even if a person has an idea for business, and giving them strength, strengthening their ideas, giving them our opinions if they ask for it, and making them feel good about the possibilities for them in the future. That is all within the mitzvah of the Hechazakta Bo. We should strengthen a person who is struggling that we learn from Parshas Bahar. May we be zoche that there are no people in our community that need to rely on others for help, but indeed that we are able to touch everyone, certainly on a physical sense that we're able to strengthen them, but we're also able to touch them on an emotional level to make sure that they have the strength to persevere through the difficult challenges that may come their way. Thank you for listening, and good Shabbos.